Hi, Luke from Korg here, and it's Volca sample time with Guitar Guitar. So we're going to take a look at the brand new Volca, the newest addition to the range. You've got the beats, you've got the bass, you've got the keys, and now you've got the Volca sample as well. So this adds a whole new dimension to the range, because of course, whereas those are the Volca's classic kind of analog sound you can get out of them, but here the sky's the limit really, what you can do with the sampler. So we're in live mode. You've also got step mode, just like on the Volca beats, so you can toggle between those very easily. So in live mode, you can play your 10 parts live on the keyboard, and then you just select the one you want to edit, change the sample, to whichever one you want to edit, and then you can change things like the start point, the length. You've got a filter on there, so that's a high cut filter, so you can filter out the highs. You can change the speed, which changes the speed that the sample plays back, which effectively changes the pitch. So there's a massive range there you can hear. You can also change other things on here, like the level. So you've got a volume control per part. You can also pan, because it's a true stereo output by this 3.5mm output here. You can also change the attack and decay in the amplifier section. So you can have a softer attack or a shorter decay. You've also got reverse per part. So if I go function reverse, that'll show me which parts are being reversed. So if I want to reverse that kick drum there in part one, I can do that or not. Same thing with reverb. Got a reverb effect per part, so I can turn that on. And then I can adjust the reverb mix there, or just kill the reverb completely. So let's have a listen to the pattern. So this is one of the preset patterns that's in there. As you can see, you can change the tempo, and it gives you a nice digital tempo readout. And you can add swing, which is a new thing for us on the Volcas. So no swing at all applied at the moment, but we can swing that. So really uber dotted. Or back to straight again. You can also mute and solo parts here very easily. Solo is function solo. So it's a solo and display. So I can easily solo and solo that. You've also got step jump, so you can do some neat fills and stuff. Again, same as on the Volca beats. And you can also change active step. So that's how many steps are actually playing. So at the moment it's all 16, but if you want to get some strange, wacky time signatures on the go, this is going to be in 15, 16 now. Here it's missing out the 16th step, but say you just wanted to do something simple like have a different time signature, for instance, do something in 3, you can just knock out beat 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, or bring it back in. This works particularly well when you've got it synced to any other Volcas or the Electrode, for example. One might be set to 16 steps, one might be set to 15, one might be set to 12. And you get some really interesting cross rhythms and patterns playing as they overlap over time. To record your own pattern, same as the other Volcas, function, clear all. Start the pattern playing, and then you can go into step mode to put in your steps. So first of all, we need to decide on our sound. So we've got some kick drum there. Let's go for that kind of more meaty kick drum. Go back into step mode, and then you can put your steps in. So it's just a 4-to-the-floor kick drum. What's on part 3? It's my claps, so I'm going to put that on beat 2 and 4. On part 2, we've got that little cowbell at the moment. So that's cabasso instead. And of course I can record live as well. And then you can play around with your sample get it to sound exactly as you want. And of course you can add swing. Once you've made your pattern, you can save. You've got 10 memories in there. Plus, we've got this really neat addition again, which is song mode, so you can actually chain together your patterns there and make 5 songs out of them, which is really cool as well. Okay, so as far as sampling into the Volca sample, there's various options. First of all, there's a really neat official Korg iOS app, which works on iPhone and also iOS on iPad as well. It's called Audio Pocket, and it's basically just a really good way to access all the factory content, but also it has a little sampler built into it as well, where you can edit all the waveforms. You can import samples from iTunes as well, and then beam them via this included cable out of your audio output of your iPhone or iPad into the sync in on the Volca sample, and you can just play it in, and then in a few seconds the data's in there. So that's one option. Second option is there's a really neat editor which has been done called Caustic Editor for Volca sample. This is a really neat piece of software which has been developed, and it's available on multiple platforms, so macOS, Windows, Android, and also iOS as well, so it's got all bases covered. And it's a really nice little piece of software. Again, you can see a list of all the factory samples. You've even got a neat little editor in there. So you just click on the waveform, then you can edit here. And as you can see, you can truncate, normalize, amplify, do fades on your samples. You can edit it, so change start point and everything. You've also got a nice little effects processor in there and some various tools. But first and foremost, it allows you to get any data from your computer into the Volca sample very, very easily. Okay, thanks for listening. This has been the Volca sample. Don't forget, of course, it runs on batteries and it's got its own little speaker built in as well, just like all the other Volcas. If you want to check them out any further, go to the Guitar Guitar website and have a look. See you later.